Hello and welcome to a special Q&A section today. I recently got a note on one of my videos saying, "Your video is a lifesaver for me. Thank you." When you receive items on the PO, does this also not put them on hand? Do I then have to adjust each of these items back out of inventory? These are really common questions, so I wanted to clear up the different types of purchasing within ConnectWise PSA, when to use each of those types of purchasing within ConnectWise PSA, and what the implications are for doing different purchasing actions. Now, to clarify, these are for inventory class products only, so I'm only going to be talking about inventory class products. And in my environments, I always have purchasing approvals turned on. So if you don't have purchasing approvals turned on, I would highly recommend having purchasing approvals. I'll cover that in another video, but you will see a purchasing approval step. So I'm going to go through the three types of purchasing directly to a job, pulling from on-hand inventory, and then purchasing to stock and picking to a job, which is what this question is really about. And I'm going to show you when to use each of those ways. So first up, we have purchasing directly to a job. And what I mean by this is you have a sales order, a project, or a service ticket, and that has products on it. When you go into your ConnectWise system, you'll be able to see in your procurement purchasing approvals any item that has ever been put on any job. These can be open job, closed job, as long as they have not yet been approved. They're going to sit here in your purchasing approvals screen. So I can see all these items here. What has to happen is these products have to get approved before they can move to purchasing. So I'll look at one of my inventory class products for a project. I'm going to select that item. I'm going to approve it. And this is for Zoom room upgrades. It's going to move to my purchasing screen. So I can see now that that product has moved to my next screen. Now, what if it doesn't? What if the product that I just approved doesn't move from the purchasing approval screen to the purchasing screen? Well, it's because I probably already have that product on hand. And that's going to bring us to number two. ConnectWise wants you to pick from your existing on-hand stock before you buy the product again. So in the example that we just had, I approved an ABC product for Zoom rooms, and it didn't show up in my purchasing screen. That's because if I go to my inventory, I can see that I have quite a bit of these products sitting here on the shelves. So these need to be picked from stock versus purchased. I want to use up my on-hand stock before I go ahead and purchase it. To pick your products, you're going to go into procurement, product pick and ship, and we'll look for my Zoom Rooms upgrades right here. I can see that the product has been approved. That was the action I took at the beginning of this video. I need to pick one, and I have 199 on hand. So I'm going to select that, actions, pick product, and now I've gone ahead and picked this item. I'm not sure what warehouse it was in. So I have to pick it from a warehouse where there's actually stock. So we'll double check that. And I think it might be in my Clearwater section. So it is in Tampa A. I'll go back. I'm going to select my item. I'm going to pick it from Tampa A. And I've now picked that item. If I look at that on-hand stock again, if I refresh this, it's going to have gone down. And now I've actually picked those units and the on-hand quantity has automatically decremented. So coming back to that original question, Do you have to adjust those items out of inventory? No. If it's an inventory class product, when you pick it, it will automatically decrement the on-hand inventory, remove that from stock, and show as being allocated to the project or the job, whatever it is. So I did go a little bit out of order. This is really what we just saw, where I approved something in purchasing approvals. We did have stock on hand. It didn't show up in the purchasing screen because ConnectWise wanted me to pick that item from inventory. Once I picked it, it decremented the on-hand quantity. Now, if we go back to number one, how about when there is no on-hand quantity? We'll go back to our purchasing approvals screen. And there's an on-hand column here. So this is actually extremely helpful in purchasing approvals. Before you approve something, you're going to be able to tell whether or not there's actually stock of that item. So I'm going to approve something we don't have on-hand quantity of, which is this amp right here for a sales order, and it's for order number 5. I'm going to select it, and I'm going to go ahead and approve it. That is going to move it to the purchasing screen, and you can see it right here. So this has no on-hand quantity. I have to purchase it. I'm going to go ahead and create a purchase order for this. And I'm going to show you what happens when I receive it. This product, this PO, let's say I sent this to the vendor, the product came in, I'm going to go ahead and receive this product. Let's check before we do anything our inventory. So in our inventory, you can see there's no amp. There's no amps on hand. We knew that. That's why we had to buy the product. We're not seeing it here in our stock list. When I receive the product, which I'm just doing straight from the purchase order, it gets picked to the sales order immediately. So going back to our inventory management right here and looking again, still no amp. It doesn't touch the stock at all. If you're buying directly to a job, to a project, to a sales order, to a service ticket, that product will never show in stock if you created the purchase order directly from that job. So when you're creating from a job, it doesn't touch the inventory management screen. It doesn't touch your stock. It gets allocated right away. If it was already in stock, you can pick it, decrement the quantities automatically, and it gets allocated. In this question, in the original question, what it sounds like was happening is that the system or someone is purchasing to stock and then picking to a job. I see this all the time. So if you're doing this, it's fine. There is actually a time and place to do this process, but I don't really recommend it most of the time. And that's because your products can be stolen and used for other jobs. So what I believe might be happening in this question is in the purchasing screen, someone's creating a manual purchase order. What I mean by that is, let's say in purchasing approvals, we'll go back maybe to this large display. Let's say I needed a large display for order number 5. If someone went to purchasing and said actions, create PO. So I'm not selecting anything. I haven't selected anything in purchasing. Instead, I'm going to purchase orders and just creating a PO from scratch. This is not tied to any jobs. This is just a general purchase order. It has nothing to do with anything that already exists in the system. And I'm going to go ahead and choose my vendor and create a large display. So I'm buying a large display right now, and I'll buy 3. This purchase order is, again, it looks similar to our other purchase order that we created earlier from the purchasing screen. The major difference with this purchase order is that there's no sales and service information. I have no idea what these 3 items are for, who they're supposed to go to. I don't know which clients have paid. I don't know who hasn't paid. I have no idea. So if we go into our inventory management again, right now we don't have any large displays. There's no large displays in stock. If I receive these three large displays, they're going to go straight into inventory. And that's because I created that purchase order. And they should go straight into inventory. Oh, they're a non-inventory class product. Incorrect. If they were an inventory class product, I would see all of those three items right here under my medium display. There'd be large display and there'd be three items here. That is not ideal because then they can sit in stock. They have to be manually picked, just like we saw when you pick something from stock and allocated to the jobs. And there's more than three of those required. So when we look at those large displays and we scroll down here, we need five large displays. Who gets them? Who is supposed to have these? Does the warehouse know who needs them first or fastest, or what does that look like? So instead of buying by going through procurement, purchase order, creating a new purchase order, and just having a purchase order for products that you think you need or you think have been approved, it's always best to make sure those products come into the purchasing screen and then purchasing directly from that purchasing screen. Once they're here and you create a PO, you'll actually be able to see the sales and service information and you'll know which jobs these products are for. They won't get stuck in your inventory. They won't get cluttered up. They won't get used by anyone else. And they're going to flow through really, really well. So as I said, there is a reason. There are reasons to use number three, which is to purchase to stock and then pick to a job. And that's mostly for products that you use a lot all the time. Cables, things that you order in large quantities and that aren't necessarily job specific. So if you have products that get used on every single job all the time, or you like to carry backup stock, sure, create an ad hoc PO, not tied to any jobs, receive it into inventory and have it sit in inventory. Otherwise, always purchase directly to a job if you have job-specific products, if you want your receiving process to be really, really clean. And as a bonus, I recommend only using one purchase order per job. So don't combine multiple jobs on the same purchase order. For one PO, you should only have one job in the sales and service information. Hopefully that answered this question. If not, post another question, ask some follow-up questions. I'm always happy to help. Remember to like and subscribe, and remember there are no bad questions. It's pretty confusing. There's a lot to learn when it comes to procurement, especially in ConnectWise PSA, and I'm here to help.